Cervical cancer is the leading cause of cancer death among women in Uganda and the fourth most common cancer among women worldwide. Combining screening efforts with timely treatment of all screen positives for human papillomavirus infection can prevent progression to invasive cervical cancer. To date, this is the most effective intervention in closing the current prevention gap. Dr. Apollo Karanzi from the Ministry of Health under the Reproductive Health and Maternal Child Care says few women are turning up for screening, and out of these, between one and four are found positive, with one being in critical condition.
One out of the four, at least one, is referred to Hoima Regional Referral Hospital or Murende for further management, but the rest are managed with the thermocoagulators by the health workers at the facility. So basically, the program is progressing with the data and records. We are moving on. Previously, data was not being taken as a quality indicator, but because with numbers, we look for performance, and work done is always documented. Spread is not worrying, but really we need to see how we can prevent. Prevention is could be the best key with routine mobilization and sensitization through VHTs, through radio mobilization, through outreaches, and now we want to focus on the males, the male engagement strategy, because when we have the males getting into women health, at least the public health issue of cervical cancer may be worked on.
Dr. Mwalimu Musheshe, the Vice Chancellor of African Rural University and lead researcher in cervical cancer screening and treatment in the districts of Kagadi and Kakomiro, says he is confident that with government efforts, the cancer can be managed. He says men's attitudes towards cervical cancer screening and treatment of their wives is also now more positive.
So I'm still very confident that working together and with all the support, government, international people, we can eradicate female cervical cancer.
Justin Tumwebaze, the Kagadi District Health Educator, says as a district, they have put the screening and treatment services at every health center 3 to ensure that women access the services at their nearest.
In Kagadi District, the turn-up has not been all that good. That's why we are now here requesting and sensitizing the community that we have those services of cancer screening and in all our health center 3s, and we are just requesting men as the caretakers or the providers of the families to encourage their women to go for cancer screening, because this cervical cancer is one of the most killing cancers in Uganda, and it is taking our women, mostly those ones who have lowered immunity.
Lucy Noeline Kansime, the project manager of the cervical cancer screening and management project in Kagadi and Kakomiro districts, says the purpose of the project is to ensure that each and every health facility in the two districts has a trained midwife with skills to attend to patients with cervical cancer. Noeline says out of the 7,500 targeted women for the 6 months period, only 982 have been screened in 3 months.
So we feel that the uptake is not yet too well because of other challenges. There are very many myths in the community related to culture, related to religion, related even to other social norms in the society.
Dr. Karanzi says the Ministry of Health has embarked on a routine human papilloma virus infection vaccination of all school-going girls between the ages of 9 and 12 to prevent the spread.
Now that the time is getting back, most are got at school, so that HPV is done to prevent the spread. But males as one component who are responsible for transmitting this across the women. We are also trying to get strategies, but the treatment in health facilities is there, the screening and management is there, the care is there, so the service package under maternal child health for cervical cancer is there, so let people go for the services at every designed health facility in our country.
I recommend women aged 25 to 49 years of age to go for cervical cancer screening.
The project being implemented by the Uganda Rural Development and Training Program with support from the Female Cancer Foundation and the Ministry of Health is being piloted in 10 health facilities of Nalweyo, Kisita, Kachindo, Kakomiro, Isunga, Buikara, Chakabadima, Chirianga, Chinyarugonjo and Kagadi General Hospital in Kagadi and Kakumiro districts. However, in Kagadi alone, the project is being run in only 6 health centers out of the 36 health centers in the district. Severe cases are referred to the Uganda Cancer Institute for further management. The Uganda Cancer Institute bill establishes the institute as a semi-autonomous agency mandated to undertake and coordinate the prevention and treatment of cancer. A 33.6% prevalence of human papillomavirus among women in Uganda combined with low screening uptake has resulted in the country having one of the highest cervical cancer incident rates in the world of 47.5 per 100,000 women per year, according to the HPV Information Center report of 2016. Report by Thomas Tumwebaze for the news.